Hello guys, in this video I am going to tell you about the KL transform. So before going into KL transform, let us see what is different in the KL transform. So we have seen the Fourier, you may have seen the Fourier transform or the cosine transform. So there what things were different was, for Fourier transform you have a matrix, the transformation matrix basically. So this transformation matrix is same for every image. So this will not change, this will change only when the length changes. So basically this depends on the length of the image, that's it. Same applies to the cosine transform. There is one transformation matrix, and using that transformation matrix you can transform any image. In KL transform, what we are going to do is, here the transformation matrix for every image will be different. This is basically what we are going to use, is we are going to use the statistical properties of the image. Statistical properties, that means we are going to use mu x, that is mean. We are going to use the eigenvectors, the eigenvalues, etc. So let us see by a sum that how we perform the KL transform. So let me just explain the KL transform using a sum. So let us take this as our sum. Suppose this is an image. It is a 4 by 4 image. Here, and we have this is a binary image. So this is the given image, and it has been told to find the KL transform. We have to find the KL transform of this image. So basically, to find the KL transform, first we need to find the transformation matrix. So if you would have been told find the discrete cosine transform or find the Fourier transform, you have the transformation matrix already. You have to just multiply it with the image and you get the answer. For KL transform, you have to first find the transformation matrix of this image. So how we will do that? There are some steps for that. First step, consider what is your object. So here let me consider that all these ones are my object. So I will first give the coordinate system to this image. So this is the coordinate system. So now what I'll do is I'll form a vector. So step one, form a vector of the object in the image. So this is the object over here, my image object. So what will be the vector? Let me name it x. So x will be, I will write the coordinates of these ones. So here the coordinate will be 1, 2. So let me represent it like this. Next, 2, 1. Next 2, 2, and the last 3, 1. So this is my vector x. Next what I need to find is mu x. Mu x means mean of all these values. So that will be 1 plus mean of this row first and then mean of this row. So 1 plus 2, that is 3, plus 2, that is 5, plus 3, that is 8. 8 divided by 4, because I'm taking the mean, so there are 4 values. So 8 divided by 4 gives me 2. And here 2 plus 1, 3. 3 plus 2, 5, plus 1, 6. 6 divided by 4 will give me 3 by 2, that is 1.5. So this is my mu x. The next thing that I have to find out is, so this was basically step 2, finding mu x. Sorry, finding mu x. Next thing, that is the step 3, here what we have to do is we have to find the C matrix. This is the basically covariance matrix. So here the formula for this is expected value of xi minus mu x into xi minus mu x transpose. I'll tell you what this is. Xi basically denotes all the different vectors of this vector x. So let us first find x1 minus mu x. So x1 minus mu x is nothing but this first is x1, this is x2, x3, x4. So this is x1. So what you'll have to do is you have to minus this from this. So what you get, 1 minus 2 will give you minus 1. 2 minus 1.5 will give you 0.5. So this is x1 minus mu x. Next, you have to find x1 minus mu x transpose. So that will be nothing but this is a column vector, there will be a row vector, minus 1 and 0.5. Next, you have to multiply these. So there's a multiplication over here. So for that, you'll get c1. So c1 is equal to minus 1, 0.5, minus 1, 0.5. So you have to do basic matrix multiplication. So what you get over here is minus 1 into minus 1 is plus 1, minus 1 into 0.5 is minus 0.5, 0.5 into minus 1 minus 0.5, 0.5 into 0.5 0.25. So this is your c1 matrix. Next, similarly find c2. So now we can see c2 will be nothing but x2 minus mu x. So 2 minus 2 is 0, 1 minus 1.5 is minus 1.5, minus 0.5. This you'll have to multiply by its transpose. So it will be 0 minus 0.5. So what you get is, zero into zero, zero into zero, then 0.5 into zero is zero, and you get 0.25. Next, you have to take C3. So C3 will be 2 minus 2, that is again 0, 2 minus 1.5, that is plus 0.5. This will be multiplied by its transpose. So 0 into 0 again 0, 0, 0, and 0.25. Next, you have to find C4. So C4 is 3 minus 2, that is 1. 1 minus 0.5, 1.5. 1 minus 1.5, that is minus 0.5. Multiply by its transpose. So 1 into 1 gives you 1. 1 into 0.5 gives you minus 0.5. Minus 0.5. And this will give you 0.25. So this is basically your what we call C1, C2, C4, C5. So how the number of these will decide the number of C1 to C4 basically. So there were 4 over here, hence you are getting 4 over here. So the next step is you will have to find the C matrix. So the C matrix was expected value of these. So that just means the mean of all these 4. So how will you find the mean of all these 4 is, take the first element, so this is 1. Add all the first elements, so 1 plus 0 plus 0 plus 1, that is 2, divide by 4 because there are 4. So 2 by 4 will give you 0.5. Next, over here, this is the second element, so minus 0.5 plus 0, 0, minus 0.5. So this will give you minus 1 divided by 4. Minus 0.5 minus 0.5 will give you minus 1 divided by 4, that will give you minus 0.25. Next, over here, minus 0.5 minus 0.5 will again give you minus 1 divided by 4, so that will again give you minus 0.25. Over here, 0.25, 0.25, 0.25, 0.25. So you basically into 4 divided by 4, that will give you the same answer. So this is 0.25. So this is the covariance matrix C that we have found over here. Next, what we have to do is we will find the eigenvalues and eigenvectors of this matrix. So we have to just find the eigenvectors and eigenvalues of this matrix. So how will you find that? So basically you have to replace the diagonal elements, so that becomes 0.5 minus lambda minus 0.25 minus 0.25 0.25. Also note one thing that is important, that always this matrix will be symmetric. You can see that the values here is 0.25 and here is a minus 0.25, here also minus 0.25. This is very important. Always your covariance matrix will be symmetric. This is the property of the covariance matrix when you find it out. So next, what you have to do is you have to find value of lambda. Oh, here also there will be a lambda. So this will be nothing but matrix multiplication basically, and 0.25 ka square. So let's work this out. So here you will get 0.25 into 0. So when you equate this to 0, basically you get this equation. On further solving this equation, you will get lambda square minus 0.75 lambda plus 0.0625, that is equal to 0. This equation you will get when you solve this equation. So further solving this, you will get lambda 1, that is equal to 0.6545, and you will get lambda 2, that is equal to 0.09549. So these are the two values of lambda that you will get. So next, what you'll have to do is you'll have to find the eigenvectors corresponding to these two values. So the eigenvectors, these are the eigenvalues, or these two. Now eigenvector for lambda 1. So for eigenvector for lambda 1, what you do in this equation, substitute lambda. So substitute lambda is equal to lambda 1 first. So you will get here 0.5 minus, what is lambda 1? 0.6545, 0.25, 0.25, I guess it is minus, sorry, it is minus, and here you will get 0.25 minus lambda. So this, next x1, x2, this is the eigenvectors, equals 0. So you can solve this. When you solve this, you get minus 0.1545 minus 0.25 minus 0.25, and here you get minus 0.4045. Next, open this. So you will get 0.1545 into x1, basically converting into equation, minus 0.25 into x2 equals 0. You can open any one of this, you will get the same answer. Next, what you do is minus 0.1545 x1 is equal to 0.25 x2. You can also open this, huh? You will get the same answer. So from here you get x1 is equal to 0.25 upon, you'll get a minus sign, 0.1545 x2. So this comes around minus 1.6181 x2. So that is the relation. So from here you can write eigenvector equals, here when you put x2 equal to 1, so here when you put x2 equal to 1, you will get x1 is equal to minus 1.6181. So hence our eigenvector will be, when x2 is 1, x2 will be down. So when x2 is 1, x1 is minus 1.6181. So this is the eigenvector corresponding to the eigenvalue lambda 1, eigen lambda 1. Similarly, we will find the eigenvector for lambda 2. So eigenvector for lambda 2, same, we will do 0.5 minus what is lambda 2. We have lambda 2 is equal to 0.09549. We got from here 0.25 minus 0.09549. So this will be equal to x1 x2 0. So when you further solve this, you will get (0.4045 - 0.25 - 0.25) (0.15441 x1 x2 0). You can take any row and you can expand it, so you will get 0.4045 x1 - 0.25 x2 = 0. So you get 0.4045 x1 = 0.25 x2. So from here you get x1 is equal to 0.25 upon 0.4045 x2. You can also expand this, you will get the same answer. So here you get 0.618 x2. So therefore eigen vector will be, when you put x2 is equal to 1, this x1 is equal to this. So when you put x2 is equal to 1, you get x1 is equal to 0.618. So therefore the eigenvector is, when x2 is 1, this is 0.618. So this is the eigenvector. So you have done almost everything. Now you just need to make the transformation matrix. So the transformation matrix is given by let me denote it by A. It will be a matrix where you have to write the eigenvectors corresponding to the largest eigenvalue first. So here you will have eigenvector of lambda 1, then eigenvector of lambda 2. Basically, by lambda 1, because lambda 1 was greater, here 0.6545 is greater than 0.09549. So therefore lambda 1 should be like this. So in general, A is given by eigenvectors lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3, lambda 4, up to lambda n in general, where lambda 1 is greater than lambda 2, greater than lambda 3, greater than lambda 4, etc., up to lambda n, and lambda n is the least. So like this. So here you will get A is equal to What was eigenvalue eigenvector related to lambda 1? So that is minus 1.6181. So that will come over here. 1. Next, here 0.6181. This is your transformation matrix A. So you have find out the transformation matrix. Now the transform will be given by Y, will be the output of the transform, that is given by A, that is over here, into input image X minus mu X. So this A is over here. Input image X is basically our vector that we were finding. This is the input image X, and this is mu X. So we know these values and we can find out the transform. So basically you are asked to find out this transformation matrix. So this is important. So let us stop over here. I hope you have understood everything over here. You can always ask me any doubts in the comments. Thank you so much.